Welcome back to School of Civil Engineering. This is Atula with another new video. Actually, we have started learning about auto revert toolbar. Okay, auto revert toolbar in AutoCAD. So actually, what is that? By using that auto revert toolbar, we can create detailing very easily with bar bending schedule. So from here, first of all, when you open your home, then you have to come here auto revert. Actually, you'll not get default here, okay, you'll not get here default, just you have to install that. And when you will install your auto revert software, then it will create a plugin here, and by after that you will be able to use that toolbar. And if you're new here, you can watch our previous lecture, that playlist is given in description as a auto revert tutorial series. Okay, so by using that, I mean from the tutorial playlist, just you can learn or you can download that software freely. Now first of all, in this lecture, I'm just before starting, just we have to change some setting. So first of all, we have to go here, sorry, if you see here, our toolbar is not showing here. Just I'll click here, then show menu bar. So it's here now. Just we have to, first of all, we have to page setup. So I'll go quickly here, dimension style, then standard. After that, I'll go here, modify, and sorry, I'll just close that. First of all, I'll go for format, then unit setup, then from here decimal, then precision. This is the precision, and our input value will be in millimeter, MILI millimeter. Okay, it's done. So okay, it's done. Now when it's done, after that we'll end here. You can use decimal, then you can use the architectural, okay, then you can use engineering. So if you select engineering, just see here, when you use select engineering, then take your mouse and you will read it carefully. After that, I'll just use, then you can also select architectural, but I'll select decimal. Okay, then 0.2, then everything is okay. Now I'll just click okay. After that, I'll go format, then dimension style. So from here, I'll go here, modify. Here I'll just click modify, standard modify, then first of all pair primary decimal, and I'll just select that. Okay, it's okay. And when that's okay, after that here text, okay, it's showing the value of text. Then I'll just give here, suppose 10 mm, and our sample arrow, I'll also give it suppose 5-6 mm. Okay, then click okay, then set current, then close. Now it's done. And also we have to come here, change, and here unit. Okay, this is, sorry, here this is very important, the model unit represent. Okay, the model unit represent, which unit the model represents. So just you have to click here, millimeter or meter. So I'll just select millimeter, right? Model unit represent millimeter. After that, layout unit represent also millimeter. Then river local dimension unit, it's also millimeter. Then river diameter unit, it's also, it's given also millimeter. Then river total length, okay, river total length unit, it's also in, you can give it meter or millimeter. I'll just give it river total length is in meter. Then our river spacing unit, okay, river spacing unit, this also in millimeter. Then extension unit, it's also in meter or millimeter. I'll just use meters. And unit of mass, you can use your pound or kilogram. I'll use kg. So it's done. Then click okay. So it's done. Our the format is ready. Now suppose go home, I'll just create a cross section of a suppose column or beam. I'll just consider it's column. So I'll just take here, So I'll open ortho, right? So when it's done, I'll just give here. Suppose cross section will be considered the 600 mm. Enter. Then it's not showing. Then click here, regenerate R, escape. Then click escape again, escape. Then click RE. Okay, then enter. Now it's showing here. And also I'll just right click here, sorry, just I'll move it here. Now I'll right click, and from here I'll just select show or hide, so it will come here. So now when at that point is ready, now again I'll go here for our next line in that direction. I'll consider this is 400 mm, then I'll go in that direction. Here and here, so it's done. Now see here, it's done. Now we'll just select that and we'll join it Z. Now our cross section is ready. Now we'll take our here, we'll just take our that columns clear cover. So I'll just simply click use offset O, then enter a specified distance. It will be column, suppose it will be 75 3 inches. Okay, consider it's 3 inches, 75, then take it here. So it's done. All right, it's done. Otherwise we can remove that, delete. Just when it's done, now we can go directly auto river. Okay, auto river. Now we'll draw here strip, as in cross section we'll draw first of all strip. So simply click here strip. So when we have click strip, then it's showing us diameter. What's the diameter of our stirrup? Then give a 10 mm, I mean millimeter. Then specify the concrete cover. Okay, concrete cover, what will be the concrete cover? 75, then enter. So specify the first corner, simply click from that corner to that corner. Just see here, this is our here this is our river stirrup. Now see that it's not a perfect shape. So after drawing here, simply click auto river here. Okay, now see here, this is here our the shaver. Okay, but just if you see here, our that text are showing in large format. Okay, so we can also change that. Simply select it, and from here you can select new scale. Otherwise you can go here for scale. Okay, you can select from here as per your requirement. Suppose 1.15, then okay, and again select it. Now click here scale. Okay, and just give here the scale size, suppose it's 0.5, then enter. Sorry, it's being very small, it's not showing. Control Z, then again click scale, sorry, escape. First of all select, then click scale. Now give here the scale, suppose it's 5. Give here escape, escape everything, then select. After that click scale, and now just give here suppose give 4, then it's also very small. So we can also use click first of all, sorry, escape, first of all select, then click scale, then give here the scale value is suppose 10, right? Then enter. So now it's almost okay, but I think we should use select, then scale. I think we should give here 7. Maybe it will be right. 7. Okay, it's right. Just see here, it's right now, and it's also showing us the length, river length from that point to that point in millimeter, that point to that point in millimeter. Okay, so actually that point to that point, cause from 400 millimeter, from that point to that point, that is 400 millimeter, and another clear cover is 75 millimeter, right? That's why it's showing us the length is. Now we'll just see here, it's not showing like a thick, so just we can click here, go here by clicking here. So river, just you can use double line or thin line or thick line. I'll use thick line. Okay, then okay, now click here, river, select and click. After that you can select that and you can click here edit, and from here you can select the thick, then okay. Now see here just how much it's looking very gorgeous. Okay, now when it's done, now we have to go for our river. So I'll just select that option river, and it's showing the diameter of river. Here it's given 20. I'll just give 20 diameter, then enter, specify the intersection point. Simply click here and see here, this is your river. And also if you want to give crosshair, then simply select that, edit, select that, then edit. Sorry, you can go here, setting, then river, then here crosshair, it's showing none, and you can give it the internal plus or external plus. So I'll just give internal plus, then okay, just see here it's showing like that. So you can take it similarly, take here, then 20, then specify that point, so it's here. Now also similarly you can just copy that, copy it, and just simply click CO, then enter, and specify the base point. Just you can specify the base point, and simply you can take it here according to requirement. Suppose here and here. So in this way, just you can give the reinforcement detailing for your stirrup. Just see here, it's done. Okay, it's done. Just see, it's done. So how easily we have created our that modeling, I mean our detailing for our columns or beams. So this is the cross section of our columns and beam. And also you can take a thin layer for it, and as a engineer, and I think you know that how we'll create a thin layer for your outside bar. So in this way you can do it. Now we'll go for our bar bending schedule. So just I'll create bar bending schedule for our stirrup only first time. Okay, so it's not zooming out, so I'll again click RE, then enter, then see here it's zooming out very much. Now I'll just give a mark. Okay, so simply click a mark 1, and from here select the river. So I'll select that river, and from here I'll just take a line here, then enter. So it's showing here the value. Okay, it's showing the value here, but it's showing very small. Okay, it's showing very small. So simply click here, then click scale. Okay, click scale and give here suppose 10. Now it's little bit okay. Again click scale, and I'll also increase, I'll give here 15, then enter. Okay, now it's okay. Now when it's done, now see here they have no value. Actually here just giving l equal to 2. Okay, here l equal to 2, it's giving length. Now I'll just click here and I'll click edit. Okay, when edit, now it's showing us this is the n means the number of stirrup. Here n means the number of stirrup. So they have two way to use your Actually, there are two ways to use your that total value. So just you can give here simply the number of step and here spacing. Okay, you can give here spacing and here number of step. Otherwise you can give here spacing. Suppose our spacing will be 100 or 125. Okay, suppose our spacing will be 125 millimeter and total length of our column, if that is a column section, then what will be the total length of our column? Suppose our total column length will be our total column length will be for our suppose if we consider that is for three story building, then our suppose I am considering that is for one story building, so total column length suppose it will be 3 meter. Okay, and this is column stirrup. Just I'm giving here a name, then click OK. Now see here, it's giving you the data, the file. So, okay, it's giving you the data here. All data are given here. Also you can again click here and also you can edit it, right? Sorry, it's manual. Here spacing, that is the spacing. Okay, I give here, simply give here the number of stirrups. So consider that our number of stirrups will be, what will the number of stirrups? 3 into 100 divided by 125. It's 24 stirrups. So number of stirrups 24. Okay, then it's done. Now just simply click OK. Now here our number of stirrup is 24 and the length is 2 meter. Okay, the length of our that stirrup is 2 meter. Here it's giving us the length of stirrup. Actually we have given here, if we go here in setting, then unit, so from here we have given extension unit, it's river total length unit in meter. Also you can give it in millimeter, there have no problem. If you give it in millimeter, then click OK. Now see here, it has changed to millimeter. Okay, so it's done, right? It's done. Now click here simply bar bending schedule and click here. Now see here, it's not moving actually. So again click RE, regenerate, enter, then it's moving. Now it's showing us, this is our shape, just simply this is our shape, and here our total length, a quote quantity 24. Okay, then here the mass kg 22.7 kg, then percent of total 100%. Okay, note CS, I mean our column is stirrup, our column tie. Then here total requirement is, just see here, 23 kg. So in this way, just we can simply make our bar bending schedule, and also we can create detailing for our stirrup. So in our next video, I'll just show you about that, how we'll draw, I mean how we'll create our column detailing. Okay, and also how we'll create for our foundation. So thank you very much. Stay connected till next video. And if you think that's helpful for you, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon so that you get every update ever first. Like our video, share our video, and don't forget to leave a comment. Your own like and your own comment inspires for the next ride. So thank you very much.